Tina Spaulding, Trance Channel, here today for video 9 of our Ascension series. Sorry for the break in production there. I was sick last week and didn't feel very good, so apologize for that. I'm feeling fine now, though. Let's see what Jesus has to say to us today. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. And as you are all working through your energetic transformations, you are going to encounter what you may deem to be some negative experiences. This is what happened to our dear one last week. She was given a message via her body to eliminate some things that she was consuming that were no longer in accord with a 5D frequency. And the message was loud and clear, and she has heard it. So we want you to understand that as you are going through these energetic shifts and changes, this is not going to necessarily be an easy journey. We call these, and many others call these events, ascension symptoms. What are ascension symptoms? Well, as you are being upgraded through light codes that are coming to this planet from the galactic central sun, these are light codes that are full of information, that are full of stimulation for the neurological system that you interpret the world through. You interpret the world through your body, mind complex. That means you see, you touch, you feel, you taste, you hear. These are your five senses. Well, we, as you understand, engage in the sixth sense, which is expanded consciousness. Now, when you are going from five senses to six senses in a conscious way and in a rapid way, that is what is happening to a lot of you right now. There are physiological adjustments that must be made because you are rapidly changing your consciousness and your body being a much slower frequency, being a much lower frequency, has to try and catch up. Now, what this can result in is things like sensitivities to food or overreactions to situations. And this may be deemed as inappropriate or unfortunate or unwanted. But this is what expansion looks like. Just as when you are going from being unfit to fit, you have to get aches and pains because your muscles are being used in a way that they weren't before. You're having to work through resistance. You're having to kind of force yourself to maybe get up and go for that morning walk, whereas before you would loll around on the couch eating toast or something. You are often in an uncomfortable situation if you are going from a state of lower frequency to a higher frequency in a way that you understand, such as physical fitness. So somebody may be quite overweight, sitting on the couch, eating inappropriately, not exercising, and they come to a place where they are no longer satisfied with the choices they've made and the results of those choices, because that's all you're experiencing if you are overweight, sluggish, and depressed. You are experiencing the consequences of the choices you are making, both physical, mental, and emotional. So what's happening as a collective right now is that there is a collective agreement that you are not satisfied with the status quo. And most of you will agree, you're not satisfied with the status quo. You have been sending up many, many prayers. You have been focusing your attention on improving the quality of life for humanity. You no longer want to see wars. You no longer want to see hunger. You know that there are enough resources on your planet to solve these problems. And you know that the current systems are diverting those wealths and riches into other places that are not beneficent for the overall health and well-being of humanity. So what's happening on the collective level is that you are praying for change. When you are praying for change, just as when you are that unfit, overweight person who has decided that things need to shift, When you're praying for change, who walks through the door but a personal trainer? What does that personal trainer do? Do they tell you to keep laying around and overeating? No, they say, come on, get up. Get up and we're going to go buy you some running shoes and we're going to go buy you some exercise clothes and you're going to feel uncomfortable. You don't want to go in the store. You don't want to try things on. You feel unattractive. You feel bad. You feel shame because you know that you have done this to yourself. And there is an aspect of that that is arising in your society right now. You all know that you have been participating in the systems that have brought this society to the precipice of self-destruction. You've all been participating in buying unnecessary plastic items at Walmart. You've all been participating in driving gasoline-powered cars. You've all been participating in factory-raised foods. You've all been participating in eating genetically modified foods or foods that are sprayed with toxic materials. You understand that you are supporting these systems, and there is a feeling of guilt and shame that is arising in many of you. We do not want you to feel bad. What we want you to do is, just like the person who has now been taken out of the house by the personal trainer, we want you to amend your behavior. We want you to amend your behavior knowing that change is inevitable, knowing that change is coming to this planet whether you want it or not. We want you to amend your behavior in several ways. First of all, forgiveness. Forgiveness for yourself for any system that you have participated in. There are some political movements right now that are trying to make you feel bad because of what you've done or what your ancestors have done. And that is ego-driven guilt. We want to be clear here. Anything that is making people feel guilty is an ego-driven thought system, and we do not support it. What we support is forgiveness. That means you forgive yourself, you forgive your ancestors, you forgive those beings who are mad at you for what your ancestors have done, and you come together to amend future behavior. This is not about making anybody shameful. This is about amending future behavior. So just as the personal trainer will not berate you for what you have done, they will say you are living with the consequences of what you have done. You are being punished enough. If you are feeling sluggish and depressed and overweight and you don't enjoy being in your body, those are the natural consequences of the choices you have made. You do not need to be punished further. It is unpleasant to have those experiences, and it is those experiences that motivate somebody to get up and start moving and changing the way they are eating. If you attack yourself for what you have done in the past, your frequency will immediately plummet and you will feel terrible. And that is of no benefit. That means you're being unloving to yourself. You're being unloving to the past you that didn't know any better. And that is why we do not want you to participate in any political movements that make you feel bad about your past or your ancestry. It is not your fault. It is past. That means it is over, it is done. The only way to shift and change the natural consequences of behavior is to change the behavior. The only way to change the behavior is what is driving the behavior. What is driving your behavior? Your beliefs about reality. And this is where we come in. Your beliefs about reality are being rapidly shifted to such a degree that you are confused and upset, and the body is trying to keep up with these changes. The body is sort of dragging behind or lagging behind the shifts and changes in your consciousness. So if you have been doing a lot of forgiveness work, if you have been doing some mind training program, perhaps that is getting you to be more positive, looking at the good in your life, appreciating gratitude practice, these kinds of things, your body is going to cease to match your mind. Your mind is going to be changing much more quickly. You can, in fact, change your mind instantaneously. You just have a realization, that moment that you call a penny dropping realization, an epiphany. An epiphany can happen in your mind, and in that moment, your mind has shifted, but your body has not shifted to match it yet. And that is where you can start to have some physical symptoms coming up, because the body then is trying to, we'll say, eliminate from its structure that which is no longer in accord with the mind. So if you're doing a lot of upgrades in your mind, you're going to get a lot of shifts and changes in the physical body, some of which may be perceived as negative. Do not perceive them as negative, but understand that you are being shifted and changed on many levels. So what is a healing? A miraculous healing is a shift, an instant shift in the physical body. This can happen under certain circumstances. But what is happening for you as a society is that you are healing yourselves. You are going from ignorance to understanding. You are going from the shadow to the light. You are going from deception to truth. And all of those things are going to manifest in your physical structure in some way, in body, as in symptoms of becoming sensitive to things that you used to be able to do but you can't now, becoming emotionally sensitive. So, for example, not being able to tolerate ways that you were compromising yourself previously. You may be coming to the end of your rope with certain relationships or certain behaviors, saying, I can't do this anymore. This is not, there is nothing wrong with you. This is you upgrading. This is you being upgraded. This seems to be coming from outside in the sense that it is coming in the form of light from the galactic center. But in actual fact, it is coming from the billions and billions of prayers that you have all sent up saying, I don't want to do this anymore. There must be a better way. We must change our society. This isn't fair. There are too many poor people. There are too many people who can't get medical attention because they don't have insurance. There are too many rich people who are taking everything. It is not fair. Let us change this world in some way, shape, or form. These are the prayers that we have been hearing for decades, and they are powerful because you are powerful. Now, the amending behavior must be that you believe in your power, that you believe in your ability to manifest that which you want, that you believe in your ability to shift and change the systems that you all have unconsciously been supporting. Stop supporting the systems that you do not want to thrive. If you are engaged in a system that is known to be immoral or doing illegal things or things that you do not believe in, take your attention away from it. Disconnect from that system and find a system that is in accord with what you want to see on this planet. This is very simple. There are 8 billion seemingly individual souls on this planet, and you have the power to change everything. You have the power to change everything by first changing your mind and understanding that you are contributing to the collective, and then making your behavior reflect that new understanding that you are going to create a new collective. You are going to create a new collective. So, starting today, we want you to disconnect from some system, behavior, food, drug, addiction, maladaption that you have become very well aware of in the last few weeks. It could be a social media platform that you're following. It could be a relationship that is no longer in alignment with your beliefs, where you're compromising yourself all the time to keep the other person happy. You don't need to, quote unquote, dump them. You can tell them that what you're talking about no longer resonates, that you don't want to keep going to the bar for drinks, that you don't want to keep doing this. It's no longer suiting your increasing frequency. And if they agree with you, perhaps they agree with you. Perhaps they have been feeling the same thing, and social pressures have kept you behaving in old-fashioned ways. Now is the time for awakening. Now is the time for kindness. Now is the time for forgiveness. And now is the time for transformation, willing, conscious transformation. And so today we challenge you to break free of something that you know is not serving you. And we want you to be happy about it. We want you to cheer yourself on because you are evolving and you are reinforcing the transformation of your mind with behavioral confirmations of that transformation. And in that, you will be shifting your timeline. You will be creating for yourself a new future, where these old limiting beliefs and ideas and behaviors will no longer rule you. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I'll speak to you again soon. Wow, that was great. Okay, so I got my message last week, and mine was related to foods and drinks that I consume. So that has been taken under advisement this week, and I'm doing much better, and I will continue to do much better as I remember that painful several days when my tummy was very, very upset and continues to be upset if I do not give it clean and healthy foods. I just want to remind you that we do have our t-shirt shop up and running on Etsy. The link is below. I am wearing one right now and it's. What does it say? Infinite patience brings immediate results. These are lovely, slim-fitting, they're called tri-blend t-shirts, and we are introducing new Course in Miracles sayings each week. So do go check that out, and thank you for joining me. There'll be some other links in the description box to direct you to other aspects of my work, aspects of my work that you may be interested in seeing. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again soon.